hey you, do you like small LEGO sets under $10? Or maybe you're looking to stock up on some LEGO Ninjago sets retiring soon? If you give me just a few minutes, I'll tell you if this little thing is worth your money. Dungeons of Shintaro, which was the name of Ninjago Season 13, was definitely one of the best seasons of the last few years, and it had very unique fantasy-like Dungeons and Dragons aesthetics, and it gave us some wonderful sets like Skull Sorcerer's Dungeons or Skull Sorcerer's Dragon. And these little things, known as LEGO Ninjago Burst Spinners or Capsules. Even though in TV show only Ko achieved this so-called burst form, there were three of these sets, one for Kai, one for Lloyd, and of course one for Ko. This small set known as LEGO Ninjago Spinjitzu Burst Ko was released in the beginning of 2020 in Europe and half a year later in the US, and it was retailing for 9.99 euros or dollars, and it's expected to retire any day now. I picked this one up because Ko's minifigures seemed the most universal of those three, and I was really curious about the team, and yeah, because it was heavily discounted. This is how the box looks. It's definitely a very original packaging in quite a unique shape, and if it weren't for the logo, I'm not sure if I'd recognize it's a LEGO set at the first glance. There's an over-the-top graphic on the front, general concept behind the set on the side, some extra artwork, and that's all. And oh, the instructions were in the form of a flyer instead of a booklet, which I think is something you'd expect rather from a polybag, not a boxed set. This is how the entire set looks like after you build it. It's a small thing and, well, to be honest, even just by looking at it, you can say that it's a bit of a downgrade compared to Ninjago Season 12 arcade pods. Let's start with the base. I do like this orange, black, dark bluish gray color scheme. It makes me think of rocks, stones and lava, which is how any LEGO Ninjago Dungeons of Shintaro sets should look like. It's shaped correctly, but you won't find any mind-blowing techniques used there. Of course, it's always nice to have some extra round corner plates or wedges. The central elements of this model are a black projectile launcher and the Technic gear rack connected with some pins and axles, and then finished by this big gear wheel from one end and a hole on the other. Let me show you the most interesting part of the set, which is this capsule. It takes only 7 elements to build it, a blue rubber band, a round 2x2 plate with rotation stem and screw, 4 gorgeous looking marbled trans-pearl gold energy burst panels with white clip, and this interesting black 2x2 modified brick with bar handles on each side. The last two types of parts I've mentioned are unique to these smallest LEGO Ninjago dungeon sets, and as much as this modified brick with bar handles is useful and mockable element, I cannot say the same about those burst panels. They simply won't stay in one position due to this white clip, and this is by design. They are holding together only because of this rubber band, and it should make the play feature, well, playable. That's kind of a shame because they look really gorgeous, and yet the usage of these parts outside of the set is very limited due to that white clip. Together it forms a ninja launcher or a burst spinner if you prefer to call it that way, and it's the only play feature of this set. Well, you can say that the entire set was supposed to be just a one big play feature, and it's shown right there on the box how it should work. You put it in place, you slam it, the capsule should open up like a deadly flower, and then it should close while spinning. Now, watch this. First, I thought it's just me. I'm doing it the wrong way. I made a mistake while building something like this. But then I looked up some reviews online to see how can I make this thing work, and it turns out I cannot. The whole design is just very faulty, and this is the case for everyone. If you're lucky enough, the capsule will open ever so slightly and just for a millisecond. Disclaimer, after several more tries, I managed to get it to open, but only when I hit it really hard. So I can't really imagine a kid operating it properly, and kids are a main target audience for this set. It spins nicely on smooth surfaces, but just won't open up. I tried to fix it by putting this rubber band below the marked line, and then it spins poorly and it won't close back up. If you have this set and you were able to actually play with it without any issues, do let me know in comments below. Do let me know if you weren't as well. I'm really curious about your experience. By the way, remember my review of Cole Speeder's car from the Ninjago Prime Empire season?
I remember.
I said there that play features of the Speeder car are heavily reliant on your imagination. That was a fun set, really encouraging to grab it and play with it, and its price was exactly the same as this Ninjago Burst Co. And yet, this set here doesn't even inspire me to imagine anything. Well, I imagine not buying it in the first place, but I was curious about it and it was really cheap, so I have no big regrets. Moving on to the main reason I bought this set, Cole Ninjago Season 13 Iteration, also known as Spinjitzu Burst Co. It comes with two headgears, a classic Ninjago one in black with dark brown headband, and an Asian-inspired black hat. They come in several other sets, but they are good, but nothing too special. So are the legs. Nice prints, but I have two other Ninjago sets where Cole has these same pants. I'm always a very Lego-positive person, and I disagree with this cool kid's philosophy of being overcritical or even fanishly hateful over everything that Lego Group does, but I must say, if you're selling the set with non-fully functional filler model and one minifig, even if it's one of the cheapest Lego sets in a box, it would be nice to have some unique elements there. The torso and the head are beautiful, prints are amazing, especially this back one with a lava dragon's head, and they would be unique if it weren't for the LEGO Ninjago magazine's foil pack, which featured that same minifigure, and it did so much cheaper. Oh, and you have two spare parts, one trans-clear cheese slope and one small black 1x1 square. Just as the entire set, they are kinda meh. This set was cheap, I bought it discounted, I was really curious about this Ninjago Spinjitzu Burst Spinners concept, and yet it was the only so far set from Ninjago that actually disappointed me. It contains of only 48 pieces, and yet I'd say it feels like even less. Honestly, I had foil packs from LEGO magazines which were more complex and more fun to build than that. You cannot properly play with the only play feature of this set, and it was supposed to be the reason why people would pick this set up. And it contains of some interesting looking elements, and I mean these Spinjitzu Burst panels here, but they are just not much of a use outside of this set. This minifigure looks cool, but you could get it as a gift from LEGO Ninjago magazine and for much cheaper. And if you want to get this minifigure, there's always Bricklink, because I know that they don't have LEGO magazines in the US, so I'd recommend checking Bricklink for these offers before rushing to the store and picking up this set. Sadly, from all the LEGO Ninjago sets retiring in 2021, this will be the one I won't miss. If you like what I'm doing here and you'd like to help me out so the mythical YouTube algorithm would recognize my existence, you can always give me a thumbs up, leave a comment below, watch my videos from the beginning to the end, or subscribe to my channel. But for now, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you around. Bye!